What's up everyone, welcome back into another interesting video, and today we are going to talk about the latest Android 16 Beta 1 update. And before we move further, let me tell you that this is a huge update from Google after a long time. So I'll be discussing everything what I found in this update, so make sure to watch the video till the end. And if you are new to the channel, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button right now. So firstly, starting with the settings UI, so finally Google has added some colors. I mean, it's been a long time since they added the monad colors, and at some point, I was really missing those colorful icons that we used to get before Android 12. Now when we look upon the about phone section, it mentions the model as Pixel 7a because this is a GSI ported from Pixel 7a. So when we check the Android version tab, it obviously mentions Android 16. And if you look upon the Easter egg, so there's not a major change in the Easter egg animation, and you still get the space game like we used to get in Android 14 and 15. And for the security patch, so this GSI comes on the latest security patch of 5th May 2025. Now if we look upon the home screen, first thing you will obviously notice is this new Wi-Fi and battery icons. And this looks similar or exactly same to what we get in the latest iOS. I mean, was Google running out of ideas for these icons? But to be honest, I really liked it. And obviously, you still get the status bar clock on the left side. Now for the home screen features, so there's not much of a change. I mean, you still get the same app drawer and the home screen. But now they have also added this app list button. When we tap on it, it just opens the app drawer. I don't know whether it was a good idea to implement this, but anyways, if we move further and check the wallpapers and styles, they have also added a rework to the animations and interface. Like when we swipe down, you get this kind of animations, and that looks really great. I mean, even when you swipe the wallpapers on the left side, it looks good. Now you get this new colors tab where you get multiple color styles for your UI, which was there before. And other than that, you can also control the color contrast from here. So increasing the contrast makes the colors more bold and deep. Moving back, if we tap on this icons button, you can control the themed icons from here, which works perfectly fine on your home screen. And you can also customize the layout or the app grid size. So if we talk about the lock screen customizations, so for the lock screen clocks, you can customize the lock screen clock font style by adjusting the values. And this is something new I have seen in Android 16 update, and you can also change the clock colors from this tab and even customize the luminance, like increasing it lightens the font and decreasing it makes it darker. And you also get this option to adjust the size. Moving back, if we check the lock screen clocks, so yes, you still get those same lock screen clocks introduced in Android 14, nothing new, but that's it for the clock customization. If you look upon the recent menu, you get this app title right here, which we previously used to get on the top. And yes, as this is Pixel Launcher, so you can directly copy the text from any app. And other than that, if you tap on the app icon and check the app info, so they have also made a bit of change in the app info UI. Like firstly, they have made some changes regarding the button style, but other than that, there's not a huge change. But for the most interesting part, which is the QS panel, it looks really amazing. I mean, not only you get this latest QS panel, but also they have implemented a lot of changes here. Like firstly, starting from the top, you get this kind of status bar clock right here. And even they have introduced this new brightness slider. And to be honest, I have mixed feelings about it. But anyways, for the most interesting part, it's not gonna disappoint you. Firstly, when you tap on the edit button right here, you can adjust the tile size as per your choice. Like if I tap on the Wi-Fi icon and then slide it towards both the sides, I can change its size as per my choice. And not only that, you can add up to 4 tiles in a single row. And even while you're editing the tiles, the animations are really great. So now you can keep the tiles of any size you want, and I really love this feature. I mean, after a long time we are getting something new and fresh, and that looks really great. And by the way, you also get this new volume panel, which also looks pretty decent. Now I talked about the QS panel customization, but if you ask me what's new in the QS tiles, so I found 2-3 features. Like firstly, you get this new record issue feature. What it does is, it looks for any issues regarding your experience or bugs. Like you can select the issue from here, whether it's regarding your performance, interface or any other stuffs mentioned here. And then you can enable screen recording to send the feedback to Google. and it might fix it later in the future updates. Apart from this, I also found this new VPN tile, but currently it's not available in my region, so I don't have an exact idea how it's going to look. So if you have a Pixel device and you're currently running the beta one, let me know in the comments. So yes, that's it for the UI changes, and now moving into the settings, as I already told you that you get this new colorful icons for every other settings. And now when we open the network and internet settings, you get this kind of grid lines in between all of the tabs. So yes, this is also something new I've seen for the first time, because from Android 12 to 15, the settings UI look like this. So they have also added some UI changes in the settings other than the colorful icons. Now for the latest features, so you get this adaptive connectivity feature, which tends to extend battery life and performance by managing the network connections. So yes, this is a new feature. Now if I talk about the app features, so there's not something new. All they did is just added the screen on time from the digital well-being settings. Though you can still access it from there, but yes, you also get an extra option from the app settings to check the screen time. Other than that, when you move into the display and touch feature, now you get this touch sensitivity feature, which improves the touch response while using a screen protector. And if you ask me that how much space does the system consume, so after Android 16, it's about 19 to 20 GB, but it might differ considering your device, RAM and storage type. Alright, moving to the battery tab, yes, it crashes. Probably a GSI issue. But still, I can share what's new. Now, apart from the regular battery saver, there's a new option called the Extreme Battery Saver. So when you turn it on, firstly, it enables the dark mode. And now if we check the home screen, it also limits most of the non-essential apps and only allow essential ones to run. So this is a really great feature if you have problems regarding your battery, and you can also customize the app options from this tab. Now apart from this, you also get the adaptive battery option, which tends to optimize the app battery usage so as to extend the battery life, but it may reduce the performance and cause delay in the notifications. Talking about the latest system features, so everything seems to look same apart from this new repair mode. So enabling it reboots your phone into a special environment where all your personal data is hidden. So this is a great step for privacy, because many users worry about their data theft during repairs. So with this repair mode, your data stays hidden and safe while the phone is being fixed. So yes, that's all I found regarding the latest stuffs introduced in Android 16. And if I lie my conclusion, so this is a major update regarding UI and design. I mean, after like 3-4 years, Google has finally done something new, which we can actually consider to be a big update. Whether it's the QS panel or the settings UI, I really loved it. But if you were concerned about the AI features, sadly, I was unable to access the new features introduced in Google Photos. It's probably due to the fact I'm using a GSI. But anyways, this is all I found regarding the latest beta 1 update. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button right now. And anyways, goodbye and take care.